What is the criteria for an autism diagnosis? According to the DSM-5, which is the American Psychiatric Association's Diagnostic and Statistical Manual, which is the most current one, there are two sets or categories that they put the criteria in for autism, which are social communication and interaction and restrictive and repetitive behaviors. The diagnosis is based on these symptoms either having been previously displayed or are currently displayed. Symptoms must begin in early childhood, even if they're not recognized until later on in life when those social demands exceed that person's capacity, which is how late diagnoses happen, especially in females like myself. For a diagnosis, symptoms must cause a functional impairment. In addition, these symptoms can't be better explained by an intellectual disability or a global developmental delay. And within this first category, all the criteria must be met. Persistent deficits in social communication and social interaction across multiple contexts, as manifested by the following, currently or by history. Examples are illustrative, not exhaustive, see text. Number one, deficits in social-emotional reciprocity, ranging, for example, from abnormal social approach and failure of normal back-and-forth conversation, to reduced sharing of interests, emotions, or affect, to failure to initiate or respond to social interactions. Number two, deficits in nonverbal communicative behaviors used for social interaction, ranging, for example, from poorly integrated verbal and nonverbal communication to abnormalities in eye contact and body language, or deficits in understanding and use of gestures, to a total lack of facial expressions and nonverbal communication. And number three, deficits in developing, maintaining, and understanding relationships, ranging, for example, from difficulties adjusting behavior to suit various social contexts, to difficulties in sharing imaginative play or in making friends, to absence of interest in peers. Now, within the second category, two of the four criteria must be met. Restricted repetitive patterns of behavior, interests, or activities, as manifested by at least two of the following, currently or by history. Examples are illustrative, not exhaustive, see text. Number one, stereotyped or repetitive motor movements, use of objects or speech. For example, this could include simple motor stereotypies, lining up toys or flipping objects, echolalia, idiosyncratic phrases. Number two, insistence on sameness, inflexible adherence to routines or ritualized patterns of verbal or nonverbal behavior. For example, extreme distress at small changes, difficulties with transitions, rigid thinking patterns, greeting rituals, need to take the same route or eat same food every day. Number three, highly restricted, fixated interests that are abnormal in intensity or focus, for example, strong attachment to or preoccupation with unusual objects, excessively circumscribed or perseverative interests. And number four, hyper or hypo-reactivity to sensory input or unusual interest in sensory aspects of the environment. For example, an apparent indifference to pain or temperature, adverse response to specific sounds or textures, excessive smelling or touching of objects, visual fascination with lights or movement. Now, once it is determined that someone meets those criteria for an autism diagnosis, a level is going to be assigned. This level is based on the amount of support that they need. Now, this level assignment does take into account co-occurring specifiers, such as intellectual disabilities, language impairment, medical diagnoses, and other behavioral health diagnoses. So level one, autism requires support. Level two, autism requires substantial support. And level three, autism requires very substantial support. If you want to learn more about the autism levels, I actually did a collaboration with Indie Andy, another autistic YouTuber, and it's over on his channel. I'll go ahead and link that somewhere for you to check out if you'd like to learn more. I hope this video helped you learn more about what is required for a diagnosis of autism spectrum disorder. If you enjoyed it, go ahead and drop a like. And if you're interested in learning more about autism from the perspective of an autistic adult, me, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And I hope that you're having a wonderful World Autism Awareness Week.